points went off. He had, I believe, what, 47 points and 46 points?
Randy Woods, one of the leading scorers in the nation, and you can see he has the NBA rating point on that. Now, Frazier Johnson, after the rebound, it won't go. Neubauer comes away with it. Jack Bird for three. Got it.
A lot of credit to Woods.
Twice down the court, he has found people. Last time, Neubauer for three. You know, that time it hurt. He's unselfish. He found the open man and got him the basketball. Wide open, top of the key. He swings it over to first. Starpin will not go. Johnson is right there for the rebound, but he travels. Temple scored the first 4 points of the game, but since then it's been all LaSalle. Back to Philly in a moment.
How can it be that an automobile, a mere 9 inches larger on the outside, gives you over 2 feet more room on the inside? Maybe it's the new Meta. The all-new 1992 Toyota Camry. We just couldn't paint well enough alone.
Have you ever had an instant party? It's easy, and you don't need balloons. Just stop by Subway and order a sack of different subs. Take them home and slice them up and serve them family style. It's more fun because everyone gets a taste of everything. So if you need to feed 100 people on short notice, if unexpected guests drop by unexpectedly, or you just don't feel like cooking dinner tonight, pick up a sack of subs at Subway. We specialize in solving emergencies with food. For more information on these and other fine sandwiches, visit the Subway near you.
Dan Larson knows a secluded course where the holes are challenging, but the fees aren't. Now, where do you suppose he'd rent a car? Budget, where every rental passes 25 quality checks and price is not a handicap. The smart money is on Budget. Now at Budget, get an economy car with unlimited mileage for just $99 a week, $24.99 each additional day. The smart money is on Budget.
Randy Everready Woods decides to take a three-pointer. Now, this is not a pro three-pointer. This is a volleyball line three-pointer. See it right there? This is known as a spike. And Mr. Everready says, oh, enough of this.
That's it. There's three. He's on. Watch out. Could be a big night for Randy Woods. And you can see with three-pointers like that, why he's one of the leading scorers in the nation. He can knock them down from everywhere. Woods again from three, and well beyond the strike, rattles it in.
Oh, I told you, he feels it. I feel it for him.
And he's whistling back up the court.
You know what's nice about that, Charlie? I've often mentioned that. Out of a timeout, you know, all the good coaches, and Speedy Morris is one, always has never set play. That was a set play against a zone. More times than not, you'll see it against the man-to-man. But they got a screen for him, which was a really nice play, and a good call from Speedy Morris.
11-0 run now for the Explorers of LaSalle.
Settle has jump shot for a perimeter. There. You pass the ball right there. There it is. You're going to shot it all night.
Starpin again short with the three-pointer.
Oh, what a nice pass.
Neubauer dumps it back out to Bird for three.
Wow. Basically, LaSalle has no inside game at all. Now, we saw a game last. Can you win a game from the perimeter? Last night, we sat there and watched NC State with Tommy Cugliano knock down eight.
And the Owls working it around, looking to see if they can spring a man free inside the zone.
It's going to be tough until they get some perimeter shooting right there. You've got Kilgore Kristoff. You're going to get that shot.
Kilgore around his man Hurd. The shot is short, and the Levers hauls it down.
Woods dribbles into traffic and dumps it off for Hurd. Off the iron, a rebound to McKie.
There he is, Victor.
Reluctant to shoot that center. Reluctant to shoot. Zone defense will be effective if you don't take the shot from the perimeter. Someone has to take it. John Chain, Jim Malone, someone for Temple is going to have to shoot it.
Take a look at the three-point field goals. Here it is. Now, four of them already. There's the Fraser Johnson. Turns around and hits the shot. Really not surprising to see LaSalle taking all the three-pointers. They are third in the nation in three-pointers made per game.
And they attempt 25 three-pointers a game. Temple will be taking 18 per game.
Holland, nice fake, and then rolls it in.
What do you mean defeat? Nothing personal. I didn't think you had to jump from that far away. Stay on the ground.
Johnson was open momentarily inside, but McKie didn't see him.
Victor Kostarfin is so wide open.
McKie now. We have an offensive foul underneath against Strickland, I believe, as he's banging away trying to get three down low.
You got a feel for Kostarfin. Last year, you know, had him several times. He can't take that shot. He's a pitcher. He's certainly popular, but he's wide open.
I mean, as they say in the schoolyards, he's a self-check. He's guarding himself right now. They don't have to be concerned with him. Someone has to take the perimeter shot.
Confidence is lost. Woods, nice move into the lane. Woods wins it up. Ooh, he's quick. LaSalle is up by 12. Brunson into the game. He's a freshman out of Salem, Mass. Strickland jump hook is short. Here he comes. Shaking and baking, swings it out to Hurd. No good. Kilgore with the long walk. Looking for Jones.
Hey, John, if Jack Hurd had hit a couple of those three-pointers, this would have really been something, I'll tell you. LaSalle played very well.
LaSalle has come out as if fired out of a cannon. They're up 20-8.
It was just another Saturday afternoon. It's all those old guys came out of the woods with axes. Just when they thought it couldn't get anywhere, it did. They even brought their own music.
Awesome! Hey, fellas, how about a cold bud?
A bud?
Obviously, we thought alike.
Oh, that's cold. You could hitch a ride on a comet. You could body surf a landslide. You could hang glide from an eagle. You could book a flight on a lightning bolt. Or you could drive a 1992 Toyota 4x4.
Forget the limits of ordinary basketball. You've entered the Nike Flight Dimension. Examine, if you will, Scottie Pippen, about to discover the power of his flight shoes in a time warp. And so, history gets a lesson in the Flight Dimension.
Son, you can make hundreds of dollars a year in professional basketball.
How to beat a zone, we talked about ball movement and people movement. It's really nice when the same guy does both. And here's Randy Woods, splitting a seam. Oh, how nice.
So far, he has been spectacular. Everything advertised and more. Tremendous quickness and great range.
Get out of a timeout now, and with an out-of-bounds play, a lot of times you'll see a set play. Looking for something in particular.
Tipped away by Randy Woods.
maybe saying that name quite a bit tonight, John.
Yeah, I have that feeling.
Again, the zone is swinging it around, Jones. On the other side, that's Brunson, the freshman. Rattles in and right back out. Neubauer runs it down for LaSalle.
That's the first change. John Chaney, Green, and Brunson to hit that jump shot. He can. I saw him in warm-ups. He is a freshman, but he can fill that up. We see man-to-man defense now. And he's going to try. And that's going to be tough to guard Woods in man-to-man.
Well, Neubauer's thought Woods was cutting one way. He went the other way, and it goes out of bounds.
John Chaney must have a lot of confidence in Brunson because two things. On the offensive end, he's got to take the shot. On the defensive end, he's guarding Randy Woods. Ref is telling, give me the basketball. Don't be bouncing it everywhere.
Look at some more scores around the country.
I was told if you weren't shooting well, you wanted to get on track. The easiest place was the top of the key rather than that wing shot. Could maybe put Brunson top of the key and swing the ball and see if he can get a shot there. It's a little bit easier.
LaSalle has gone ball. 4 for 14 from the field now. There's Woods. That one won't fall. And Holland follows, crashes it off the glass. Foul will call against LaSalle.
Very nice double screen, though, freed Woods for that shot.
Ron Holland picks up his second foul of the game. So Wooten will come into the game. Blitz Wooten, number 31 for the Explorers.
Brunson would stay right at the top of the key. Swing the ball, and there he is. He's got to be ready to shoot right back. He's got to be ready to shoot it when he gets it. McKie wants to take it. It's a tough shot from the wing.
Jones is blocked by Blitz Wooten, but it's a foul.
Did you say Wolf Blitzer? Blitz Wooten.
They've got some of the great names or something.
Oh, and how about their recruits coming in next year? Looking at some excellent names like Romaine Lettuce Hayward. That's right. Turquoise Mott and Kareem Towns.
Jones and Fangs in the free throw.
And a name from the past, Mike Melchione. Right, the, I believe, the nephew, cousin, or certainly related to Willie Melchione. There's an old main team here in the South, I guarantee you that.
No question. Neubauer with a little pressure on him now, brings it across the timeline, then into the paint. And McKie reaching in is called for the foul.
And what nice job by Neubauer. Incidentally, last year, he turned the ball only 15 times. Against that pressure, I mean, that's terrific. And you can see how he handled it well. Doesn't have great speed and quickness, but he's intelligent. He also handles the ball. He's got a nice handle.
Oh, it's... He'll let it go from everywhere.
I like that, my guy. How cool.
Man on him. Far out.
And that runs his free on the wing.
Somebody take the top of the key, jumper. It's easier.
Jones from the corner. Again, no good. Brunson going after the rebound. Fouls Blitz Wooten. Australian Open coverage continues on ESPN. Stephon Edberg against Wayne Ferreira, and Jim Curry will go against Richard Krajicek. Krajicek, though, defaults due to injury. We'll see Monica Seles and Mary Jo Fernandez as well. Woods is free, hangs in the air off the glass. Jones with a big rebound.
Really missed a wide open player down low that time in getting the ball to Woods.
Nobody seems to want to step up for that.
There's the guy who can do it.
But since he can do it, no good. Wooten with the rebound. Woods is free on the wing. Bird into Wooten. Doesn't hit anything.
Jackson trying to push it up before his ultimate set. Oh, nice job by Hurd. He's gripped the ball, and then Jones commits the foul.
So frustrating for Coach. What are you going to do? I mean, they wide open shots, and you're getting your feet set. Right here is an opportunistic defensive play.
Team fourth. Paul Burke, number 23, checking to move down the lane.
They struggled thus far for Temple. 8-12 to go in the first half. They had 9 points.
They're going to try to do with defense. They're picking up a little more pressure. See when they get deep. Now, Sal runs an excellent 1-4 offense. Oh, Burke all the way. Oh!
They're going around again. Paul Burke. Temple is 0-11 from 3-point range and 4-18 from the field. Larson into the paint. An offensive foul. Send it the other way. That's his second foul in the game. John Saunders along with Jim Valvano. Jim, Temple has 1 point in the last 5 minutes and 5 seconds. They missed their last 9 shots from the field. They're not getting it done. What do you do?
I think there's two options to have against the zone. Number one now is to drive again. Swing the ball and then split a seam and then try to make a shot that's even closer inside the foul line, or go back to trying to just dump it inside and go for a power situation. Or third, John, take a shot from the top of the key. That's what I'd like to see once.
Or fourth, load up the butt.
Too soon, too early for that. They'll be back.
Burke is stripped by McKie. Last touch by LaSalle. So the Owls will reload.
Then try to do it with defense.
Temple guards have yet to hit a shot from the field.
So the ball comes back. You can try it from the top if you like.
McKie along the baseline. A blocking foul is called down there against Loco Levers. Levers out of Amsterdam, the Netherlands. Just the fourth team foul on LaSalle. Underneath, nice quick pass and converting down there is number 23, Aaron McKie.
Hurd fell asleep that time as McKie just stepped right in front of him. And Speedy's letting him know it.
Almost stripped away by Strickland. Levers finally does come up with it. Go go on him quickly. Burke with a nice job of swinging the ball up. Back to Jack Hurd. Three-pointer's no good. McKie from the corner. Blocked by Blitz Wooten. Our starting for three. Again, it just will not go. Levers on the break. From behind, McKie gets it. There's no push, apparently. McKie is open for three. You got to give him credit, Chip. They're cold, but they keep putting him up.
You have to. Somebody's, coach is telling you, I keep shooting.
Called a foul on Jones. He thought he had a clean strip of Hurd. Jones' second foul. Sitting at the end of the LaSalle bench, Jim, we have...
Yes.
Talk about this is your life for Bill Rafferty back in the studio.
Bill's watching. Father Green, there he is. And before the game, he came over and said to me, "Can I please say hello to Bill?" I said, "I certainly would." And then he just offered this, Bill. He said he taught you in English and theology. And I said, "Oh, how did Bill do?" And he said... There was a Milky Way wrapper. You could put a Milky Way wrapper between both a pass and a flood for Bill Rafferty, those two parts. Bill, this is your life.
Well, Sal turns it over. Of course, Rafferty played here for the Explorers. We didn't believe him, but We looked it up. We looked. He really did play. The turnover by LaSalle. Going inside to Strickland. He's bumped down there. Number five in the game for LaSalle is Atiki Colombo. The freshman out of Virginia, but actually lives in Zaire. McKie from the corner, no good. Bird pulls it away. Wooten can't handle it. Three on one. Nice job by Woods. A tip away, but Strickland, the first ten. And a charge is called on Woods. Offensive foul as he used the elbow, the official says. To get free with man. His second, and a technical now is called.
That was coming from before. If you recall, when Woods, the ball went out of bounds early, and he didn't throw it right back to the official. Officials remember that. And in that particular case, I was watching it, when the ball did not go, he did not call a foul, Woods went to pass it to his team and out of bounds, but he did hit the opponent with his elbow. The ref saw that, called it. The facial expression.
Maybe a few words to him, man.
Few words. And that's the worst possible time. On the road, your possession, after a score, you get the two shots and possession.
Johnny Connick will shoot the technical.
Ray finishes the goal, though. For Temple, one out of two. Would be very happy with it right now.
Temple just two of six from the line right now. There's a look at Randy Woods, obviously disgusted with the last few turns of events. Toss of 1 point and the ball, though. Temple on an 8-0 run right now. McKie along the baseline, three, and he gets fouled by Colombo.
Nice move, driving. You got to drive. Either go inside with the pass or penetrate the zone. That's what they're doing. And it's a good, quick move on the baseline. There he goes. Quick move. Right by, got fouled there, and then got fouled again by Colombo, who I believe we saw coming into the arena with the raincoat, didn't we?
With a trench coat.
With a trench coat.
Yes, he was. What a great names. Colombo is actually a cousin of the Kimbi Mutombo.
Mutombo.
Of the Denver Nuggets, former Georgetown Hoyas.
So when you introduce him, it's, you say what? This is Atiki Colombo, San Lolo, Dikembe Mutombo.
Just a three-point game now. The Temple Owls have climbed right back into it.
They've done it with defense, too. They really stepped up defensively and caused LaSalle to turn it over.
Oh, underneath is Neubauer, wide open. Extended, and he was able to sneak in beneath the defense.
That was one of those switches where you don't call it, but you guys got it.
Johnny Connick steps up. Speedy Connick, wow. Speedy's going nuts.
Oh, he's going out to the travel there. And
swing it around for her. No good.
I think Speedy's right, too. I believe that was a travel.
He took two steps to the three-point line before he let it go. Over the top, Strickland back out. Johnny Connick to the corner, another three-pointer. The Owls have the lead.
That's something just like that. But defense really, I think, has put their offense in a better rhythm.
What a spark for Connick. Seven quick points off the bench. Burke lets it go. That's short. Gilmore has the rebound. Nick Gilmore up to three. No good. But the Owls control the long rebound. On a 16-2 run, Johnny Connick is going to hit over three in a row.
John Chaney kept searching.
Speedy Morris wants the timeout. Johnny Connick with the 10 points off the bench, a 19-2 run.
this was me with dull gray hair. I looked washed up. Then I found a whole new way to make my gray look great.
Introducing a new kind of shampoo from the makers of Just for Men Hair Care called Great Looking Gray. Great Looking Gray does more than clean and condition. It gets rid of the dullness, even yellow buildup, brings out the real silver.
What a difference it makes.
New Great Looking Gray shampoo. And for stubborn yellow, new Great Looking Gray anti-yellow treatment. Every second of an asthma attack can feel like an eternity. That's why there's Primatene Mist. Primatene opens clogged breathing tubes in as fast as 15 seconds. Primatene Mist, the fastest type relief known.
Okay, let's do it.
It's fast moving, hard running, non-stop, and it's horrendous. Mickey Rourke and Don Johnson bring all the action in Harley Davidson and the Marlboro Man. Coming February 19th on video cassette and laserdisc.
Here's what Speedy Morris was upset about. You'll see Johnny Connick catch the basketball, and when he catches it, right, it's hard to see, but right there, he's established a pivot foot. So when he takes that one step right there, that is a travel, because he's picked his pivot foot up and put it down. That caused that three-pointer, and also that man, ooh, what a reaction he had.
Speedy was hot. Well, he should be. Just the same, Connick is as hot as you can get, knocking down the 3-3 corners in a 10-quick run off the bench, a 19-2 run. Neubauer trying to beat his man, Carl Starkman.
Woods has been very silent after a great start.
Nice dunk down by Neubauer, but Hurd can't convert it. Crashing the boards, Hurd finally does get it.
Wooten made that. He kept the ball alive, so Hurd could convert. Good aggressive play. And LaSalle has changed its defense to a man-to-man. And now Temple would have a real advantage inside. Look for them to go a 3-2 set and get that ball inside.
Connick trying to move a little closer. He is fouled. Jeff Neubauer is whistled. Speedy on the officials again. He thought maybe there was a push-off on the way down.
We may see another technical on the LaSalle side.
If you read lips, folks, turn your head for a while. We're into the bonus, a 1-1. The man who's been the man of the hour right now for Temple is the guy in the line. Temple's last 10 points, you see his averages, just over 2 points a game.
Well, he comes from a school, produced a pretty good player here, Mark Meakey.
Yeah. Last touch to Megan and Saginaw. Temple turning up the defense again, tipped away by Johnny Connick. Nice job by Neubauer to escape two outs.
Amazing how the defense really makes your offense.
McKee's three-pointer won't go.
Well, I know John would have liked him to set up and take advantage. They finally see him man-to-man, what they would prefer to play against.
Hurd from the top of the key is short. Kilgore has the rebound, and he's fouled on the way down by Wooten. Everybody, more college basketball coming away on Saturday. Nice doubleheader. Clemson and Maryland out of the ACC, then Georgia Tech from the ACC moves in to face Louisville out of the Metro Conference, who you saw earlier here tonight.
Kilgore's on the line, only a 58% free throw.
Frazier Johnson Johnson comes into the game for Temple. Strickland will get a break. Ray Schultz is now in the game for LaSalle. Kilgore misses the free throw. Now we know why he's down in that 58% range. Connick's 12 points already, tying a career high. The foul on Scarpin as he thought he had stripped Neubauer.
I love to watch the coaches work. John Chaney was struggling against that zone, so he had to take out the big guy, Frazier Johnson, try to get some shooters in. Brunson couldn't hit it. They couldn't get it down, and finally he found the right guy, John Connick. Now LaSalle goes back to man-to-man, back in with Frazier Johnson. But you need your team to recognize that. So next time down, our Temple should really set up their either high-low post offense or their 3-2 and get it right inside. They'll probably get an easy bucket or possibly a foul, which would put them on line for 2 shots.
Neubauer knocks them both down, gets it back to a 2-point game.
Let's see what LaSalle is playing defensively.
Here you back to man, and you want to go right inside. Right inside. Trying to set up Kilgore with the height. There it is. Good recognition. And is back. Bingo.
That's nice. You see, that's good coaching, and it's good recognition by your players, if they have to.
Nice job. And a good call by the guy sitting next to me, too. We're approaching the 1 minute mark now. Intense defense by the Temple Owls. Woods can't get a shot off. Works free, loses the ball, but Johnny Connick is called for the foul. A little tap from behind.
And make no mistake about it, Temple's offense is a direct result of their defensive activity. They were really a little lethargic offensively until the defense picked up, and that loosened them up on offense.
See, and now Speedy Morris has a decision to make, John.
Does he stay with that man? He knows he can't guard Temple down low, man. Does he go back to his own?
Wood misses to the front end. The Temple Owls with under a minute to go. He's going inside. Shot clock is still on.
Oh, that's an offense.
Tough shot by Wilbur. Connick throws it up. It rattles down and in. And Neubauer is whistled for the foul as well. A chance for a 3-point play.
Mick Kilgore got away with forcing something instead of just... And now he's tying. First the jacket, then the tie. I mean, he got away with one. And that, even that play, when you talk about the principle of verticality, but the play even before that, let's take a look here. Look at that. I don't know. That could go either way. Players allowed to jump straight up.
Connick with a career high 15 now, coming off the bench.
Oh, what a terrific game. Oh, it's going to be close to five.
Swung around for Wooten. The shot won't drop. Schultz trying to go after it. Woods gets it. Won't go for him either. And the Owls will have a chance to add to their 7-point lead. Kilgore at the other end. Woods tipped it out of bounds.
Johnson here to Coach Chamber.
Coming up at halftime, Chris Fowler and Bill Raftery, the explorer himself. Highlights of Missouri, Notre Dame, Florida State, and Georgia Tech. And Bill Raftery will take a look at Villanova. McKie hanging in the air. Count it.
What a great move. That's twice he has scored. More and more teams play man-to-man out of bounds. Used to be so. And what happens then is those individual matchups, when a guy steps one way and goes the other, watch that. You see him step one way, go the other, little head fake, hesitation, that's twice. When you can score 5 points from out of bounds play, his shirt's coming off next, that's it. His shirt's off next.
Speedy is doing a slow strip tease over on the sidelines now. Well, he should after watching his team's big lead disintegrate.
It's so hard to stay well-dressed when you coach. It's just difficult, Chad.
We showed that the other day in the studio. McKie goes to the line, a chance to push it to a 10-point lead. Scarpin backs off of Woods.
Just now 5 seconds left in the half. Woods is going to have to get it off quickly to Colombo. Shot is no good. So as we head to the locker rooms, Temple outscoring LaSalle 29-6 in the last 8 minutes for a 10-point lead. Right now, let's take you back to the studio and join Chris Fowler and Bill Raftery.
Good Ball is brought to you by ESPN Home Video, producers and distributors of Super Slams, available at video and retail stores nationwide.
What an updated score from the ACC. Florida State's off on a 15-0 run to lead Georgia Tech. We'll keep you posted. Meanwhile, this Temple using a big run to get a 10-point lead over LaSalle at halftime. Let's go back to John Saunders and Jim Valvon.
All right, Chris Fowler, thanks a lot, and welcome back to McGonagall Hall. As you see, the Temple Owls up by 10, 38-28. John Saunders and Jim Valvano here, and we want to go over the first half stats and take a look.
John, wait a second. Before you go over the stats, I just want to bring this up. You remember the bet that I made with Bill Cosby last year?
Yes, I do.
Which resulted in myself and Dick Vitale getting on the Cosby Show. And you, we were going to have you on, but somehow it didn't work out. And well, we got a little tape. The guy's in the truck. Why don't you roll this for John? Kind of explain, you know, what happened from the Cosby.
Not really, but I just want to say to Jim Saunders.
John Saunders.
The Canadian Saunders. He didn't make it.
Just sounds good.
Let's keep your head down. John, we wish that you would have patience. Please don't cry. We wish that you would have patience. You're not on the show, but your spirit is with us the whole time.
Does he get a check?
Huh?
Does he get a check?
No, please don't mention money. You're talking to the wrong guy. John, we hope that you come back to us. Is he on a solid pool check?
Well, he's really in trouble.
Because the fellows told me, John, that you were sick.
He's got stomach problems.
Stomach problems. Okay, John, that's it. So now let's give the cheer.
Wait a second now.
You had a tough week, John.
You told Bill Cosby that I was sick. You told me you hadn't taped the show yet.
No, but Vitale said that. I was with you all the way, John. I wanted John.
You told me you'd tell me when you were going to do that thing. I can't believe it.
It's not in February, by the way. Folks, sometime in February.
Bill Cosby, of course, one of the most famous alums here at Temple. Football player here in track. Let's take a look at the first half stats now and see exactly why the Temple Owls were able to go on that tremendous run.
Right there, bench scoring. And the bench scoring really should say Johnny Gunnick scoring because he had 15 points. He was playing 4 minutes a game, averaging 2.5. And he had 15. Look at him. There it is, Gunnick with 15. McKie 10. And Woods, who started out so great, John, really was held in check by a very tight man-to-man Temple defense.
Yeah, he was hitting the three-pointers from well beyond that zone, but once they went to the man-to-man, a little trouble. Burke quickly with a man in his face.
With good defense. Temple turned around with the big.
And they're finally right deep. Woods knocks in the three-pointer.
I'm not going to say he started out that way in the first step.
So much confidence.
Uses his screens well. I mean, LaSalle gets picks for him, but he uses them well. And he shoots quickly.
Over the top to Kilgore. He was bumped in the back, though. Jack Hurd is called for the foul.
And again, as we discussed, as soon as they go man-to-man, Temple goes right inside. Look at that young man. Bill Cosby, around 1962, looking pretty good.
As we mentioned, football player and track, good athlete. Still runs a little track from time to time.
Mostly to the bank, I think, is where he sprints nowadays.
McKie thinks about the shot, dishes it off quickly, though, and Kilgore does not shoot it.
See, LaSalle went back to his zone.
McKie from outside the zone, hands a three-pointer.
Temple's playing with so much more confidence. You go zone now, they stick in outside. You go man, they go right inside. Tough decision now for Speedy Morris, what to play defensively.
Levers inside to Hurd, a nice block down there by Eddie Jones. On the run, McKie backs it back out a little, hangs in the air, won't go. Everyone goes tumbling to the earth. I hope no one was hurt in that mess.
Good decisions, though, in that particular transition game. You see McKie, who waited. He pulled himself back out so he didn't get a charge. And there's a scrum. Three on the ball.
Yeah.
John explaining exactly what took place there. McKie is open. Drives along the baseline. Up and in.
Really quick moves. McKee's really playing well. McKie kind of doing a terrific job protecting.
Jack Hurt from a long range won't go, crashing the boards. Levers keeps it alive. But finally, Jones comes up with it. Stepping in, but called for the block is Hurt.
If anything, I thought it might have been a traveling violation as opposed to a block. But when it's going bad for you, it goes bad.
Bird did step in quickly. Perhaps that little lean at the end is what cost him. Foul away from the ball, and Bird again quickly picks up his third.
And it's talking stuff.
The South Carolina number 25, Jack Bird. That's his third personal foul. Team's third.
A little frustration.
There's a bump there. You'll see a bump, and they're pushing, and they're both pushing. And on the road, it goes against the Dr. Jersey usually.
Outside, Vic Karstarpin gets it going.
The moves are rolling now.
Karstarpin.
I mean, it really on the verge right now with Sal.
See, the problem with Sal, actually, got no inside game, which they talk to. Everything's got to be from the perimeter. Woods drives in, dishes it off the Levers. Shot is short, but Strickland or Kilgore with the foul.
I talked with assistant coach Joe Mahalik before the game of LaSalle. He said that's really their real problem is if Hurd and Woods are not getting it done outside, they don't get enough points, you know, around in the blocks and in the paint. And it's tough over 40 minutes. Except when you got to give credit. They really exploited and they took their time and were like a boxer, you know, waiting. You grow impatient.
Levers with a high balance, but off the iron and to the floor. Temple's lead is at 14.
And LaSalle having to make that tough choice. They've gone back man. So now you can look for Temple to go inside. There's Kilgore.
Swinging around, and Kilgore is open, but doesn't shoot. A one-on-one move going nowhere. And Starper tries for the walk is Strickland, but the whistle is fouled offensive before the release of the ball, away from the ball.
I mean, you can have, it's a battle. I mean, right now, Kilgore hurt just every time down the court.
Now,
it's one of the things about basketball, always trying to clean up that inside the lane stuff. That's supposed to be a game of finesse and quickness.
Stolen away by McKie. Intentional foul on Neubauer.
There's a schoolyard. Grab his pants. Grab his shorts. You do that on the blacktop, you grab the shorts. I feel he's fouled there. Right? Feels like he's fouled. So he retaliates. Right there, you can't quite see it, but he grabbed the shorts. But his hand was slapped.
No question, with his third, he goes to the bench. It's a word from the coach. There's no question he was fouled to lose the ball in the first place. But like you say, you're in the other team's home gym. And the ball.
It's going to be a long 17 minutes right now for the Explorers. John Chaney's always teaching, always talking. You got to go to one of his practices at 6 in the morning. It's, he brings you coffee and some donuts.
I didn't even know there were 2 6 o'clocks, Jim. McKie in the paint hits the jumper, and he has 19. Was trying to work his way free.
Mark Sharp been holding him.
I heard Dick Vitale the other night talking about this, and he's so right. There's too much talking on the court. Talking to the refs. I mean, it's like, just play the game. There's so much. And right now, we're bordering on, I mean, you could have a little a fight here between, Kukar and Herb.
Nice block there by Strickland. Kilgore going one-on-one with Herb. Hangs on top of him. Won't go. Jones crashing the board. Kilgore gets it back. Again, no good. Jones from the other side.
Too much. Devil's got too much outside and inside right now.
20-point lead for the Owls.
No, they were winning the South 22-9.
Offensive foul as Woods lowers the shoulder on Carl Starford. He has three.
Our defense is really done. Exactly. They're doing a terrific job defensively. Here it is right there. Oh, well, that shoulder. Man has position.
Now the crowd is getting on Randy Woods. Kilgore into the lane. Making it look easy. Swings at the Woods. Tipped away from behind. Owls come up with the basketball. Are Starpin at the other end. Nice jump by Burke to get back on defense. Underneath, and Wooten puts it in and he's fouled.
Nice job by Burke. He hustled, got the steal, made the pass. That's nice to see. Good job. Here's the nice safe made the look down low. Gets it with a foul.
He's fourth. The King of Buffalo, number five. Back into the show lineup.
Wooten with a chance for the 3-point play. Gets the lead back under 20, but the Temple Owls are having their way right now with Speedy Horses. LaSalle explores. With the big 19-point lead, 45-13, they've outscored LaSalle since the 8-minute mark of the first half. John Chaney, the intense one.
John Chaney ranks third behind Tark and Dean Smith in winning percentage, and he is intense. There's an oft-told story here at Temple. John has a lot of rules and regulations. One is on a bus ride, nobody talks. Nobody. When they go to the game. Well, the players always hear that. One bus ride, the college president, Temple's president, rode the bus. The kids told him, don't say a word. Well, just so happened, the bus burst into flame, and no one would say a word. And they got off the bus all choking. Yeah, that's discipline.
That is. Smoke inhalation. Wooten up quickly. They call a foul on Burke, though. Take a look at some more scores now. Florida State, your old assistant, winning in Georgia Tech. What a job in his first year in the ACC.
I believe he said this is a piece of cake. Home away any place. Was that game at Tech?
That's Georgia Tech.
He's already won at Wake at North Carolina. I told him it's impossible to win on the road. He can't win on the road. He never listened to me when he was my assistant.
He's trying to figure out what you were talking about all these years.
What is this guy talking about? The road's easy. What a great job he's done.
Jones pushes the lead back to 21. Bangs it in. Randy Woods once again.
He certainly can shoot it. Now they're going to impress. They decided with about 15 minutes, see if we get back in this thing with pressure.
Woods on Kilgore.
Nice job by Temple. Got the ball in the middle of the floor. Brought it back out. They run their offense.
McKie down into the block. Jones turns around and won't go. Levers on the foul as he goes over the back of Brunson.
saying some things in, I guess it's Dutch, isn't it? I believe.
Yes.
It's all the same no matter what language it is.
We have no idea
what he was saying. Throwing the press on. It's one of the problems, no problem with Salle, that is really lack of a true point guard. Burke brings it up.
Colombo lets it fly. Shows some range.
Corner, Eddie Jones, no good. Burke with the rebound. One and out. McKie almost strips it away. The ball still belongs to LaSalle. What Temple has to be careful is when you have that big lead, and they got it easy, is to get away from what got you there, which was really recognizing what LaSalle's defense was and then taking advantage of it. Woods was free underneath, but they couldn't get it to him. Brunson lets it go. No good. Rebound to Wooten.
Oh, my goodness gracious. It's from the TV booth here.
Wood rattles it in and out, showing once again he'll put it up from anywhere. He gets off the butt shoot.
He never met a jump shot he didn't like. There's no question about that.
Nice job by Burke to strip it free. Takes it in for the layup.
You don't like to call a timeout, but you might think, now let's get back to what we're doing. Against the, you know, if it's man, we've got to go inside. Big zone, something else.
A little pressure. Beat the press, they get settled. Gets to look at everything. They got the man underneath. They got a mismatch down low. Strickland on the baseline, quickly trapped, finds Brunson. What was a 21-point Temple lead is down to 13.
But now they're doing a problem, slowing it down. Trying to get a good shot this time, and there it is.
Brunson hangs, but can't get it to go, and Levers has the rebound.
Can't answer anything better than that, his layup.
They go up here. Woods flying through the lane, reaching in a couple of the Temple Owls. Eddie Jones is the one who was called for the foul. Victor Carr Starvin. Jones for his third. Woods goes to the line.
Rich, I want to take a moment as we look at Steve Morris there to wish his brother Dave, who just got out of the hospital. He had heart surgery, and I know that Speedy and his son, who's on the team, and his other son, who's the manager, came over and said, would you please say get well to Uncle Dave? So we'd like to do that.
Absolutely.
Get well soon.
Nice to see him back out of the hospital. Woods gets one of two. Kilgore working on Levers into the lane and kind of bumps him. Levers can't believe he was called for the foul. He says, I just had my hands up. He's the one who knocked me. The call for the block.
The deliver 44 local Levers.
Let's follow up a little bit on that story, because Brian Mars, who is, you know, Speedy's son, his manager, came up and he said, and so did his other son. They both told me that, you know, this is this inner-city rivalry. By the same token, that when Speedy himself became ill, went to the hospital, that John Chaney came back from a game which they lost, immediately got off the plane and called the family, called some of the players, and just was so concerned. And they thought that that's something they'll never forget, the concern of another coach for their dad. It's really kind of a nice story.
It really was. A lot of crashing with Morris. That's right. Speedy Morris, 2 days after his brother had to go to the hospital for his heart trouble, Speedy started having chest pains himself. Turned out it was not a heart problem. Ball bounces off Burke and out of bounds.
And the Temple Owls will have possession. With a 13-point lead. Kilgore trying to work on Colombo. Into the paint. Stripped nicely by Woods. Karstark is back on defense, but Woods rolls it in.
Temple's been going down to Kilgore every time. They're getting away from their 3-2 offense and getting everybody involved. And Kilgore is a terrific player. He's done a good job. But sometimes when you just keep trying to go at it, you're a little stubborn. And a couple of times you get nothing. Down a trip, come empty trips down the court. See, again, they're going down to Kilgore. Side every time. And LaSalle's been a pretty good job of double teaming. See that? Making it tough for him. Another steal.
Burke comes up with it. They can get this one under double digits. Weaver gets it up and in, and he's fouled.
Like I said, you got to get away from just going to the same guy, even though it's worked a few times. That's two trips in a row. Turnovers, you need to get a shot. And now you look up and it's a 9-point ball game.
Now, this is good. This is really nice concentration and hanging on. And
LaPaul Weaver is number 44. The big
I wonder what he said in Dutch after that.
I mean, it was a little different, I think. For Jones, his fourth foul as well. ...11:21 to go in this game. Temple had led by 21. They want a timeout now, as it's down to a 9-point lead for the Owls. They get back to Philly in a minute.
Absolutely right, Chris Brown. That's Pat Kenny. What a tremendous job in his first year in the ACC.
Just like I thought. Just like I thought. And there's a guy, Speedy Marsh, you talk about paying your dues, John. I mean, he is coached at every level. High school basketball, 388 wins. Right? Terrific there. Look at that. LaSalle women in 2 years and had a good record. And the only coach, as you see there, to go from the women's team to the men's team at Division I. So he certainly has done it at every level.
Just keeps winning no matter where he is. LaSalle on a 16-3 run right now. Temple's biggest lead was 54-32. Milko Levers goes to the line. That timeout was called before he had a chance to shoot the free throws. Can't rattle that one home. So it stays at 9 for the Temple Owls.
Once again, when you call a timeout, usually you set something specific up. Not that.
Stolen away by Columbus. Oh. Stops at the 3-point line and lets it fly.
What a decision. I mean, you just got a great steal. Maybe 3-on-1. Yeah, you got a shot maybe to 3-on-1 there. And look at this. Great steal. Great timing. Anticipation. Now look at this. He got he went for your teammates. Well, he took a look. That was a decision. He took a look. He said, yep, I see him over there. I think I'll jack this one up.
As a result, that's what he's going to do right now is take a look at the play from the bench. Almost another steal, and it is a steal. Burke comes up with it. Burke's been a real spark plug off the bench. Wooten!
Runs it twice now. Has really been a tough decision. This press is bothering Temple. He needs to just, you know, get somebody in the middle of the press. Advance the ball. 7-point game.
What a quick turnaround.
And LaSalle's going back to zone. They started with it.
A little more pressure on the basketball than they had before.
But Temple better not get tentative.
Kilgore backing in.
Oh!
No good. Wooten comes up with a rebound.
I think Nick might have got away with lowering that shoulder again.
Levers swings it away on the other side. Then back underneath the Levers. Burke outside. 3-pointer is in. 4-point game.
The bus up into the South, and that's it. Unbelievable. And this press is bothering him.
Strickland is alone underneath and finally converts for the Owls.
And Speedy Morris felt that he wasn't quick enough as a team to press. Of course, the score dictated what they had to do.
the rump. 21-5 run for Temple. Johnny Connick, who had a tremendous first half, is sitting on the bench. And to Clemson. He leans in and gets it to drop. Johnny Connick, though, is ready to come back into this game. What a spark plug he was in the first half. Woods jacks it up. Burke chases it down. Finds Hurd, who has an open lane to the basket, high off the glass. Levers on the follow.
So much about basketball being a game of runs, but this has been ridiculous. So, you know, it's not that we tend to mean quick 8-2 runs, 10-2, that kind of thing. But we're looking at, you know, 20-point runs.
It's been an amazing game. As you look at some other scores from the NBA, earlier from college.
Unfortunately, someone here at the table knocked over a Diet Pepsi, which is now on the court time.
You don't know who did that.
No, it's adults. But it's one, either you or me, I think.
Whoever it is, get him out of his goal.
The ref got in, and he threw this in the water, the Coke, on the radio team here at Temple. I did it. It's my fault.
Johnny Connick is back into the game. He had the 15 points in the first half. McKie lets it fly, no good. Another rebound. Ripped out of the hands of Connick by Milko Levers.
Great rebound, strong hands by Milko. I say Milko because I don't think I can say Levers.
What a game all of a sudden. 6 points. Ron Holland off the glass.
Beautiful set play call from the bench.
That three that was going for him in the first half, there for the baseline, no good. Levers again.
And the South does a great job with its half court offense here against Maine. They've no set play.
Holland swings at the Burke. Levers outside the 3-point line, he won't take that shot. Finds his way open and hits the jumper. 2-point game.
John Temple did it with defense. And now the defense is more passive for Temple. You know, and LaSalle now is coming after him and really pressuring and putting pressure on the ball. Doing with man to man.
Defense both times has started the runs. Connick, jumper won't fall this time. And at the other end, Burke off and running. Oh, this is the layup. Gets it back though. Woods then dumps it off. Levers hits the shot and is fouled.
What a terrific pass by Woods. It's a tie ball game with 6 minutes to play. Great crossover dribble, and it didn't leave his feet. Oh, and a nice step by Levers to get to the glass there. Terrific pass. He makes this nice step.
May have been a phantom foul there. Unless he got him on the top of the head. Just the same, Levers now goes to the line. The 22-point deficit has been totally erased, and he can give them the lead. Stays tied. The crowd of McGonagall is trying to get their charges going once again. He's done a great job off the bench for himself.
And Burke, he's such a mismatch right here in size.
Kilgore again backs in on Levers, then dumps it out for McKie. Her Scarfin is open for three. That is short. At the Woods trying to find Hurt at the other end. Just a little bit off his mark. We're tied at 61.
Since the death of Ernest Killam, their sophomore who died of that rare blood vessel disease, they are blowing out Washington 32-10. 5 minutes to go in the first half. Back to John and Jim Filler.
All right, Chris, thank you very much, and welcome back to McGonagall Hall with Jim Valvano. We have seen
I wouldn't believe it, John, I'll tell you, because it was, you know, first all LaSalle. You know, there it was. LaSalle had a third, but it was early. 13-point lead. But Temple had a 22-point lead in the second half. All right? And that was wiped out with a 29-7 run by LaSalle, which took 9 minutes. And now it's tied. And I say a lot. Whoever wins the last 5 minutes, sometimes you win the game.
That's true. Certainly. Well, especially when you're tied.
Well, this game. This game, for sure. They've got back to the three out, two in, a little high, low run. It's designed to get it inside. And if not, kick it outside and hit the three. You need one of those two things. Well, if the clock runs, there it is, the inside. And there's the shot. And Strickland turns around. He's short, but Temple has gone ice cold. And LaSalle has a chance to take the lead. 1-4. Like to run screens. There's a screen for Woods. He's got it. He's tucked in there. Oh, he missed the shot. But Hurd chases down the rebound. His won't go. Levers comes up with it. And LaSalle. Burke in the lane. Hangs and hits it. LaSalle has taken the lead. Their first since it was 22-19 in the first half. Paul Burke, a freshman from Chestnut Hill Academy. He's going nuts. Defensively, offensively. He's got McKie. He's doing a job there, too.
It has been a story of bench players because in the first half, it was Johnny Connick for Temple, and it's been Burke in the second half for LaSalle.
See, there's the mismatch. See, that's the mismatch. Yeah, we mentioned it's just Burke and guard McKie down there. He's got to keep him in front of him and then double down. And let Temple take the outside shot because they're not hitting it.
McKie with 21 points now. Hurd quickly squares and hits a three-pointer. Nice screen. He comes off the screen well.
Really trying to isolate Burke defensively.
McKie finds his way free of Burke and again converts on the mismatch.
That's it, John. What he has to do, Burke, is stay behind McKie and let him catch it. Because when he tries that front, he can't do it. And then double down, because Temple's not hit the outside shot.
Randy Woods just shacks it up and knocks it down.
Like shooting.
Woods with 20.
Again, now, see, here's what the Burke's making say. Just stay behind him. That's better. Now help him. You gotta help him. Help baseline. There it is.
The help.
Here it is. That's the way to do it.
Nice job, LaSalle. Oh, Holland pulled it right into the hand, and then Strickland knocked it down. Holland had the ball and gave it right to one of the Owls.
Wow. Still, that was a good defensive series. That was the proper way to handle it. Mismatch down low. Hurd Woods. Watch him. Hurd Woods. Look at the screen. There's the screen.
Woods, nice move, but it's knocked away by Strickland. Levers diving all over the floor. Almost comes up with it. Karstarpin. Under 2 minutes to play and a 2-point lead for the Explorers. Jones can't find the handle, and Holland has it.
The numbers. Beautiful pass. Oh, no. Excellent. Woods. He looked to the left. Didn't leave his feet. Excellent pass.
Marco Levers converts it to put it back up to a four-point lead, and Temple wants a timeout. We've got a minute 35 to go, and what a game it has been from here at McGonagall.
Gillette presents Sensor, the system, the technology that will change the way you shave forever. Sensor, twin blades set on springs to read your face and respond. Independent suspension to sense and adjust to every curve of your face. No other razor comes close. Gillette Sensor, for the best shave a man can get.
Play Woods makes here. Randy Woods, right? He takes a look behind him, right? He takes a look right there, make sure no one's coming, and then he delivers the ball at the perfect time. He looks the defender off. Absolutely great play. Woods, who has 20 points, 7 assists, 5 rebounds, a technical foul, 3 harsh looks at the official. I mean,
he's got all
the
stuff. He
puts in a full night's work.
There's a look at the storyline. LaSalle, 15 of their last 22 from the floor they have made. You see Woods, as Jim just said, 20 points and 7 assists. Temple, 6 of 27 from beyond.
And now we see, John, what each coach decided. There's a change in defense, you see. LaSalle went to the zone, which offsets whatever Temple decided to mix man to man. Along with John Chang discussed, if they do change defense, what are we going to do? And that's what you see here. It's a good idea to change, too, to make them have to take the outside shot. Really good, a good decision, I think.
Jones from the corner cannot get it to fall. We're approaching 1 minute left in the game. Temple is down 4. Oh, nice move by Woods. He ripped our star, but had him going one way and was flying to the goal.
Again, really, you might think at that point they might hold the ball, LaSalle. And instead, I think Woods changed up and went right to the basket.
Kilgore is the man with the foul. We've got just 58 seconds left now. What are you thinking if you're John Chaney?
I think I'm in trouble right now. I think I'm in serious trouble. I think if you're going to see zone, right, so you're going to have to look at inside, outside.
Woods misses the free throw.
I still don't understand why people take everybody off the line. I'll be honest with you. I just don't, you know, at this point, they're not really getting a fast break on you. You might get a loose ball.
Now you allow them to bring it up. Setting up his defense is what Speedy Morris wants.
And he wants against his own them to take time, which they are taking.
Scarford from well beyond the strike. No good. Hurd has the rebound.
It's going to be free throw shooting now for the Sound.
They have to foul Burke. Speedy Morris calls a timeout with 37 seconds left. 72-67. LaSalle has come all the way back to catch that man. 72-67. LaSalle with the lead. 37 seconds to go. A reminder, following the game, stick around for SportsCenter with Bob Lee and Tom Means. All the scores and the highlights and reports, I'm sure, from Minneapolis, site of this year's Super Bowl. Going to the line will be Burke, just a 60% free throw shooter, Jim.
Well, I'll tell you, they'd like to have this guy there. This is my interesting brochure fact. Right there he is, the Wrath. 76% leading the squad. And if he was up there right now, this game would be in the bank.
If he was up there right now, or in 1960?
And look at him right there. He's right between, in the all-time roster, Bob Patak and Joseph Franciski. And here he is, Billy Rafter. We get him every week. We go after the governor. Of course, we love him.
Absolutely. Burke goes to the line to try and put the nails in the coffin. A 5-point lead right now. Oh, he rattles it in.
What a wonderful game. the freshman has had. I mean, he really came in defensively. He had a guard to keep down low. He's made good decisions, and now he makes focused free throws.
Clutch job. Swinging it around, Kilgore loses the handle, then looks for help, and right into the hands of Leavers. Woods wants it at the other end, dishes it off to Milk to Leavers.
What a nice pass.
McKie for three, well short. Holland goes after the rebound. They did it. The Explorers. What a comeback.
Magnificent. There's no mystique to play on the road this year.
Holland is free, stripped of the ball. LaSalle basketball. Just 10 seconds to go now, and the lead is 9. Tipped away by Strickland.
Just a great win. You can't say enough for Speedy Morris and his kids for hanging in there down 22 on the road, John. Great comeback. Great win.
Leavers puts the icing on the cake. Of course, the reason you hear some noise from the crowd is because all the South fans in as well. SportsCenter is coming up next. Stick around for all the day's scores and highlights. Good night, everyone.
ESPN's NCAA basketball is brought to you by Kodak Gold Film. Show your true colors. And by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light.